Hey, I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, and I've got a cool Excel tip for you today.
Hey, this is Mike Girvin at ExcelIsFun on YouTube, and I have a different way to do that.
Hey, welcome back. It's Friday. That means it's time for another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. Mike Girvin from ExcelIsFun will be joining us. Mike sent me this question. He says, all right, someone wants to do a lookup. Product 4, when they find product 4, they want to multiply all of those numbers. 8 times 9 times 5 times 8 times 4 times the quantity. All right, now, Mike said this would be a great duel. I can only think of one way to do it. Sum product equals sum product. So sum product is going to multiply a whole bunch of stuff together. The stuff in this case is going to use the offset function. So offset. Offset is very powerful. We're going to start from this top left corner cell right there. Press the F4 key. It says, how many rows down do we want to do? Well, okay, to get the number of rows down, I'm going to use the match. Match. Go find this value over here, the product 4 within this range of products. I'll press F4 there and comma 0 to force an exact match. That'll tell me how many rows to go down. Next, how many columns to go over? Well, that's 0. How many rows tall do I want? That's 1. How many columns wide do I want? That's 5. All right, so we have to close the offset, close the sum product. Press enter. That's the 34. Good. And then times the number to the left of me. Oh, shoot. You know, I'm in something called edit mode here. I want to be in point mode, so I'm going to press the F2 key. And now I can just hit the left arrow. There we go. And the answer should be the desired 170. We'll try it down here. Yep. Those comments are driving me insane. Let's undo. We will copy and then paste special formulas. There we go. Looks like it's working. And then over here, paste special formulas. And here, paste special formulas. There we go. All right, Mike, let's see what you've got.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Hey, this is a great problem. This actually was sent in from Abstractus from YouTube. He's a cake manufacturer, and I actually already did a video on this topic. But there's so many cool ways to do this that, of course, I suggested this to Mr. Excel for a duel. All right, so the way I'm going to do this, here's our products, the quantity, and we need a total difficulty score. So 5 times the whole row for product 4 in this lookup table. Now, I'm going to highlight all of the cells that should get this formula right up front. And I've highlighted that column. Now I'm going to hold Control and then highlight this one. I'm aware of where the active cell is, because when I do more than one cell formula at one time, you got to build the formula from the point of view of the active cell. So here we go. I'm just going to use VLOOKUP, right? VLOOKUP will just look up this product, right? So I'll look up this product. That'll be a relative cell reference. By the way, I've highlighted them all, so as soon as I finish the formula, I just Control Enter and it populates all of those cells. The table array, I'll just get this whole table right here. The lookup column is going to be the first column, of course. That's the way VLOOKUP works. I'm going to hit the F4 key, and then comma, oops, column index. But wait a second, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 6. We need all 5 columns, 2 to 6. So I'm just going to put curly bracket, 2, comma, 3, comma, 4, comma, 5, comma, 6, end curly bracket. Wow, this is an array built right into the formula. And as soon as we do that, this becomes an array formula because it's going to return all of the 5 numbers. So it's returning more than one number, so it's an array. Comma, and this is an exact match. So I'm going to do 0 for exact match. Close parentheses. Now, to see that this works, I'm going to actually highlight this and hit the F9 key. That evaluates it. 89584. 89584. So it looks like it's working. I'm going to Control Z. Now, that's an array of values, and we want to put this in sum product, just like Mr. Excel did. Array 1, and then I'm going to comma, and array 2. Well, I just want this. But sum product will not allow arrays of different dimensions. This first lookup is giving us a 1 by 5, and this cell is a 1 by 1. We can get around that comma problem requiring the same dimension by using multiplication. So there we go. Close parentheses. Now I'm going to control enter to populate all the cells. Oops, I want some blanks down here until I fill this in. With the active cell still selected, I'm going to hit the F2 key edit, and I'll just put a little if. If two cells to my left equals blank, double quote, then what do I want? The screen tips helps me out here, double quote, comma, and then the value of false is that big thing right there. So I come to the end, close parentheses. I hold control and tap enter to repopulate all the cells. So now if I select a product 2 and we made 43 of them, that should work just fine. All right, we'll see you next trick.
Hey, thanks, Mike. That is an excellent trick using 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 as an array for the return column. What a cool trick. Definitely a point to Mike. Hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another dueling podcast from Excel is Fun and Mr. Excel.